Good morning. Welcome to Basic Electrical Engineering, Unit 4, Electrical Machines, Lecture 19. Introduction, DC Motors. So the syllabus of Unit 4 is Generation of Rotating Magnetic Fields, Construction, Working of Three-Phase Induction Motor, Significance of Torque Slip Characteristics, Loss Component and Efficiency, Starting and Speed Control of Induction Motor, Single-Phase Induction Motor, Construction, Working, Torque, Speed Characteristics and Speed Control of Separately Excited DC Motor, Construction and Working of Synchronous Generator. So you can classify these the total syllabus into four categories. One is three-phase induction motor, the one is single-phase induction motor, DC motor and synchronous generator. So in order to understand the rest of the machine, the first thing that you have to understand is about DC motor. So we'll look at what is DC motor, what is a machine and the other things. So today's topic is DC motor construction. Now what is a machine? A machine is an apparatus using mechanical power and having several parts, each with a definite function and together performing a particular task. There are several parts which has a definite function and they are all connected together to perform a particular task. A machine is a piece of equipment which uses electricity in order to do a particular kind of work. With the classification of electrical machines are classified into DC and AC machines. In the next slide, we'll classify DC machines, not as generator and motor, a broad classification. Now, in this slide, we are bothered about the classification of electrical machines, DC and AC machines. DC machines are further classified as DC generator and DC motor. AC machines are classified as synchronous machines and asynchronous machines. Synchronous machines further classified as synchronous generator and synchronous motor. Asynchronous machines are classified as induction machines, single phase and three phase. Synchronous generator and synchronous motor are also classified as single and three phase. Now we'll see what is the classification of DC machines, a broad classification, in the next slide. The classification of DC machine. DC machine motor or a generator is classified into separately and self-excited. And the self-excited is again classified as series, shunt and compound. And compound is further classified as cumulative compound and differentially compound. And there are two in cumulative and two in differential. One is long and short shunt. One is long and the one is short. And differential also long shunt and short shunt. So this is the classification of a DC machine motor or a generator. So we'll see what is separately and self-excited machines or a motor or a Now, the excitation of a DC machine is classified into two, as we have discussed, separate and self-excitation. Separately excited is nothing but field coils are activated with separate DC source. If in a DC machine, field coils are activated or excited with a separate DC source, it is separately excited DC motor or DC generator or DC machine. If the field coils are field winding, field coils are nothing but field winding, which we'll look in the construction of the DC machine. As of now, remember, field coils or field windings, if they are excited by the machine itself, it is a self-excited machine. And self-excited machines are further classified into three categories, shunt, series and compound. It can be shunt motor, shunt generator or series motor, series generator, compound motor or compound generator. Now DC motor, we'll see general differences between DC motor and a generator. A DC machine is an electromechanical energy conversion device. It will convert electrical to mechanical and mechanical to electrical, and it uses electrical properties and mechanical properties to do so. There are two types of DC machines. One is DC generator, other one is DC motor. A DC generator will convert mechanical power to electrical power. Mechanical is the input, electrical is the output for a DC generator. Whereas a DC motor converts electrical into mechanical power, input is electrical and output is mechanical. That means we'll have the mechanical work to be done by the motor, so the output is mechanical, and we'll switch on the motor, so electrical is the input to the motor. Similarly, we'll switch on the generator when there is no power. That means the output of the generator is electrical, input is mechanical. So these are the two differences between electrical motor converts electrical energy into mechanical, generator converts mechanical to electrical. And electrical motor works on the principle of Fleming's left hand rule, generator works on the principle of right hand rule, Fleming's. Now this is the general principle. Either a motor or a generator will have field. This north pole has south pole again here, and this south pole has a north pole. these are dipoles. There are two poles. South pole has a north pole again here, and north pole has a south pole again. The basic principle behind this is a coil placed in a magnetic field. In case of a motor, a current carrying coil is placed in magnetic field. In case of a generator, a rotating conductor is placed in a magnetic field, because the input to a motor is current, so a current carrying power, so a current carrying conductor. The input to a generator is mechanical, that means rotating, so a rotating coil is placed in a generator. So whenever a current carrying conductor is placed in a magnetic field, there is a magnetic field between these two. So whenever a current carrying conductor is placed in a magnetic field, it experiences some force. That means the output of it is a force, that means there is a torque that is developed, it starts rotating. Similarly, when a rotating conductor which is already placed in this field, then there will be an EMF induced. A rotating conductor placed in a magnetic field has some EMF induced in it. So if you observe these two, there is a current carrying conductor that is placed in this and it starts rotating. And it is rotating. Now, if it is rotating in a magnetic field, there must be some EMF induced according to the generator principle. So there will be an EMF also induced in this, apart from rotating, apart from the torque, and that EMF that is induced in the electric motor is called as the back EMF. It's a very good concept, and it is represented by capital E suffix small b. So motor works on the principle of Fleming's left hand rule, and generator works on the principle of Fleming's right hand rule. If you stretch your thumb, forefinger and middle finger such that forefinger always points in the direction of magnetic field, and if you take the motor and forefinger points magnetic field and the direction of current is indicated by the middle finger, then the motion of the conductor is given by the thumb. Similarly, because the output is the motion, it is given by this. And similarly, if you observe this right hand rule, the magnetic field is always represented by the forefinger, and if you represent the direction of it by thumb, then the EMF induced or the current that is flowing is given by the middle finger. DC motor construction. Generally, DC motor is a device that converts electrical energy to mechanical energy. It has two parts. Generally, construction of DC motor and generator is same. A DC motor is constructed with two parts, that is a stator and a rotor. Stator is a stationary part and rotor is a rotating part. Stator has yoke, field winding, field poles, which is stationary in the sense which does not at all move or rotate. Rotor is rotating part, completely it rotates. Armature core, it has armature winding, commutator, brushes, bearing, shaft. This is a general cut view of a DC motor, wherein you can see this as a frame or a yoke, and to this there are field poles that are connected, and these field poles are having field windings. So all these three are stationary. Now this is the armature, and these small circles is the top view of the armature. These small circles are used in order to place the armature winding. This is called as the armature core, and you'll place the armature winding in this. And there is a commutator here, this white color, and this is black color is the shaft. So this is the armature core, this is the commutator, this is the shaft. These come under the rotor parts. Construction. A rotating electrical or DC machine has mainly two parts. One is stator, other one is rotor. Stator and rotor are separated from each other by an air gap. Stator is the outer frame of the machine and is immovable. Rotor is free to move and is inner part of the machine. So this is the stator, which is not movable, which has field poles and field windings and a yoke or a frame, and this is the rotor which moves. We'll see what is yoke. Yoke is the magnetic frame made up of cast iron or steel, and it is the static part of the motor. So what is the use of this yoke? It provides mechanical support to poles which will be connected to the yoke, and provides protection from dust, moisture, etc. Carries magnetic flux. So this is a casting or yoke or frame, basically made of cast iron or steel. And what is pole core or pole shoe? The magnetic poles of the magnetic poles of DC motor are structures fitted onto the inner wall of the yoke. See, this is the yoke, the upper part, and they are fitted on this. See, these are poles and these are field windings. The construction of magnetic poles basically comprises of two parts, namely pole core and pole shoe. Magnetic poles are having two parts, pole core and pole shoe, and which are stacked together under high pressure and attached to the yoke. The pole core is of small cross section area. This is under these windings, pole core. This is pole core of small cross section area, and its function is to hold the pole shoe over the yoke. This is a pole shoe. And pole shoe having the relatively large cross section area, it has a large cross section area which spreads the flux. Pole shoe also carries slots for field winding that produces the flux. So field winding of a DC motor are, see, these are the field windings. The field windings of a DC motor are made of copper wires wound over the slots of the pole shoes. There is a pole shoe and there are some slots inside it, so there the windings are wound. In this, the winding are wound in the region of pole core and named as field coil or field windings. Whenever current is supplied through field winding, it electromagnetizes and generates required flux. This will be supplied by some external source or an internal machine source, and it will electromagnetize the poles, the field winding, and there is a large amount of flux that is created, which is required for the EMF induction or for force development. Armature core and armature winding. So armature core is a magnetic core of laminated silicon, and it's of thickness 0.3 and 0.5 mm, and it is laminated to minimize iron losses. The main purpose of armature core is to place the armature winding, and it provides a low reluctance path to the magnetic flux. Now armature winding is made of copper, and it has large number of insulated coils, and these are placed in the armature core and connected in appropriate type of winding. There is two types of winding, lap winding and wave winding. So this is the armature core, as you can see, and there are windings, wires that are placed inside it. This armature core has some slots, and they are slots for wedges. And these are used such that the wire placed inside this will not slip away due to centrifugal force when they are rotating. And this is called as a teeth, and this is the slot, as I told you, and this is a wedge-shaped slot, and these are cooling ducts, which reduces the temperature, which rises due to the rotation of the machine. And commutator. Commutator of a DC machine is a cylindrical structure made of copper segments. They are segments basically, which are copper segments stacked together, but insulated from each other by mica. Its main function is to supply the current. The commutator and brushes both combinedly do this work, and supply the current from mains to the armature winding using the brushes. It is made of wedge-shaped segments of high conductivity, hard-drawn copper. Hard-drawn copper is used to reduce wear and tear of the commutator surface. These segments are insulated from each other by 0.5 mm thickness mica sheet. So you can see these are different types of commutators, and these commutators are insulated by some mica, the black color one, over the shaft, and this is the commutator, which is connected to the armature winding. Brushes of a DC motor. Brushes of a DC motor are made of graphite or carbon, which slide over the rotating commutator. And brushes are used to relay the current from external circuit to the rotating commutator. This is used to supply the current from the static circuit, external circuit, to the rotating armature winding. Commutator and brushes, unit of the DC motor in concert with transmitting power from static circuit to the rotating part, as I told you. So this is the commutator. This is the commutator segments having some mica inside them, and this is the carbon brush or graphite brush, which is sliding over this commutator. As you can see, this is the commutator and there is a sliding brush, and these are graphite or carbon brushes. Now shaft of a DC motor is coupled to load to transfer mechanical power. If you want to drive any other mechanical load, because this motor is rotating, you need to connect it to the other load. So it is having some shaft, a rod that is placed inside the armature core. So sometimes you can be asked, what are the differences between AC and DC motors? AC motors are powered from AC current, as the name indicates, and DC are powered from DC current. AC motors, conversion of current is not required. In DC it is required. AC motors are used where performance is sought, and DC motors are used where controlling is sought. AC motors can be single or three. All DC motors are single phase. AC motors armature do not rotate while magnetic field continuously rotates. In this is vice versa. Armature rotates while magnetic field does not. AC motors do not use brushes. DC motors use it. AC motors have a long lifespan and DC motors do not have long lifespan. Speed of AC motor is simply controlled by varying frequency. Because it's AC, it has some frequency. But in DC, there is no frequency, so it has to be controlled by varying the armature winding current. So this is one of the topic that you have, speed control of DC motors, in your syllabus as well as in your laboratory. So you have to know this point. Control by using armature winding current. There are also other methods, but this is one of the methods. AC motors require effective starting equipment to start them, capacitor or something. DC motors does not require any external support to start them. So this is the end of your Lecture 19, Basic Electrical Engineering, Unit 4, DC Motors. Thank you.